I've been throughout this month. I'm joined right now by Pixar Academy Award winner John Lasseter. You probably never tire of hearing that. He's the director of Toy Story 1 and 2, also the upcoming release Cars. John, thank you so much for doing this.
Oh, it's been great this month.
All month, John has been helping me introduce a festival of films by another Academy Award-winning animator, Japan's Hayao Miyazaki. And we're going to close out our festival with a pair of films that Miyazaki executive produced but did not direct. We begin with Only Yesterday from 1991. It's the story of a 27-year-old woman reminiscing about her childhood as she questions where she is in her life as an adult. Now, this film was directed by Isao Takahata, right. a very close friend.
Very
of
close
Miyazaki's.
Friend. Takahata-san is it, they met in the 60s when they were animating on some television shows, television animation together. They were members of the union together, and they became very close. And so it's as Miyazaki-san formed his studio, he wanted to have a place for his friend to direct films. But they always say that they don't really talk to each other when they direct films because they would just lead to arguments, you know? They're very close, though.
Yeah, I suspect that that both these guys, as accomplished as they are, particularly Miyazaki, that they're probably pretty stubborn when it comes to these kind of films.
They're both fantastic artists. Yeah.
When you talk about anime in Japan, this is it's big business in America, but it's gigantic in Japan.
It's really big because you know it is the Japanese comic book is such it's so big in Japan, and it's across all age groups. Everybody is reading their novels, or from kids to adults.
Like you'll see businessmen on the subways reading the comics.
Absolutely, and this has influenced the animation. You know, there's a very particular style to Japanese animation, and you see it across, you know, lots of studios and filmmakers and artists, and it's really influenced by these comic books, and. What's fascinating is when you think about how many animated films comes out in the United States every year, and it's been growing, which is exciting for me. It's like 10 times as much in Japan. They love animation. There's a lot of primetime animated TV shows as well as feature films. And what's interesting is I've learned this from our films being released over in Japan, is that the Japanese audience, they love sequels.
They do.
Yeah, there are certain series where they make feature films, and every year there's another installment of a feature film. And they have like, you know, number 9, number 10 of a film going on.
For a country that is accustomed to the greatness of Miyazaki, and they respond incredibly well to his films, 3 of the top 5 grossing films in Japan are his movies.
Right.
How do they respond to the 3D animation that you guys do at Pixar?
Yeah, what's interesting is that my friend Miyazaki-san really helped out. He loves our films.
Right.
He really loves the characters, he loves the stories, and you know, he really helped out. He kept telling everybody, these are great films to watch. And when Miyazaki-san says, these are great films to watch, people watch them. And and that's why, you know, I have a debt of gratitude towards Miyazaki-san and that studio over there in Tokyo, Studio Ghibli. It's an amazing place. And his films, both directed by him and directed by Takahata-san, they're so unique. They're so beautiful. The character and the stories are so special, and they're full of heart.
Yeah.
That's what I love about his films, and really enjoyable, and especially the one tonight is really special.
All right, well, let's take a look at it. Here it is, executive produced by Hayao Miyazaki from 1991. It's Isao Takahata's Only Yesterday. Hi, I'm Ben Mankiewicz. Up next, we have another film where Hayao Miyazaki served as executive producer. And back with us, as he's been all month, John Lasseter, co-founder of Pixar Animation and a great fan of Mr. Miyazaki.
Absolutely.
And not only a fan, but also a friend. John, thank you so much for doing this.
My pleasure.
Our next film is called Pom Poko. It's from 1994, and like our last film, was also directed by Hayao Miyazaki's good friend and longtime collaborator, Isao Takahata. It's the story of a band of raccoons organizing in an effort to stop the urban sprawl of Tokyo from destroying their forest homes. John, that's a theme we see again
Absolutely.
And again about the man encroaching on the environment.
Yeah. You know, this film the characters are, it comes from, it's steeped in Japanese tradition.
Yeah.
You know, these characters, these raccoons are shapeshifters, and they kind of look like regular raccoons when the humans are around. But then when they're relating to each other, they kind of get up and become sort of wearing clothes and look a little more human-like. And even in one place, they become very, very stylized.
Right.
And it's a tribute to a very particular Japanese comic book artist that both Miyazaki-san and Takahata-san really admire.
When you talk about Japanese anime, you talk about Miyazaki, but this is clearly a guy who, when he was younger and probably still now, reads other comics,
right,
watches
absolutely.
Other Japanese anime.
Well, in the same way that Miyazaki-san inspires me, there's a lot of artists that inspire Miyazaki-san. And I think that's what's kind of interesting is when you see a little moment in one of the films that is a tribute to someone, it's kind of exciting. But what's interesting about this story, you know, is that these raccoons are, you know, they're trying to protect this one area that is like, you know, and even the characters in the film look at this area and remember how the forest and the greenery and all that was around and it's going away. And that's something that really, really concerns Miyazaki-san because, you know, the sprawl of in Japan, it's a lot of people in a small...
Very small place, right.
A very small place. And in fact, what's exciting, because of the success of his films, Totoro, it was so inspiring to people that they've actually formed a fund, and they have a forest in Japan that they call the Totoro Forest that is now protected because of Miyazaki-san, his films, and how he's affecting people. And they're raising money to help protect the natural surroundings.
When
it's
they
great.
Name a forest after your work, you're an influential guy.
Yeah, it's really great. And he really cares. When you're over there, he cares about tradition. He cares about the environment. You know, and he puts that into his films.
Yeah. So what has been happening to our forest? It's only been 3 years. I feel like Rip Van Winkle.
We did everything we could to try and stop it.
But every inch of the woods has changed. How can the land be so transformed?
We're so sorry. This must come as quite a shock.
So the humans did all this themselves.
You know, I want to thank Turner Classic Movies for showing the films of Hayao Miyazaki. You know, they are so special, and they don't get the showings that they should.
No.
You know, and that's what I've always believed in. And I think that hopefully everyone who's seen his films all month will remember these. And you know, next time a movie from Studio Ghibli comes out, let's, you know, go see it because you know it's going to be great. Well, I think it's wonderful you guys have done this.
Well, thank you for saying that. And on behalf of Turner Classic Movies and myself, I want to thank you for taking the time out of, you know, you're in post-production on Cars.
Just down the hall here at Skywalker Ranch.
Well, I also want to thank the people at Skywalker Ranch, Pixar, everybody who's helped us out to do this and pay tribute to this great artist. But thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule.
It's my pleasure.
Good luck with Cars. I got to be honest, I don't think you need the good luck from me.
Well,
I think you're probably going to do just fine.
Well, we're very proud of this film, and we're doing the sound mix just down the hall here, and it sounded great. It's looking great, and we come out June 9th of 2006.
Well, it's been a great pleasure for me to talk to you. Thank you. Here from 1994, a film written and directed by Isao Takahata and executive produced by Hayao Miyazaki. It's the English language version of Pom Poko.